How crazy is this entrance? I'm at the Hatley Castle here on Vancouver Island, and what an impressive looking entrance. I don't know where the castle is. I'm guessing it's down there somewhere, but those gates look mighty creepy. Well, my friends, that is one badass castle. Totally freaking cool, right? And you're allowed to walk around the outside property. I spoke to a gentleman just now that said that they do tours inside of the castle, that I have to go online and kind of see when they do it. But every once in a while, they allow people to come inside and check it out. How freaking amazing would this be at one point in time in life to live here? Spectacular, right? And a view like that right outside your front door? Not bad. Not freaking bad. What do you guys think? Pretty freaking crazy. So spectacular. Sometimes you gotta wonder, the type of people that live in these kind of places. Insane. Ain't no van life and going on with these kind of people, that's for damn sure. But I think it's pretty rad that you're allowed to actually just freely walk around the yards here. It's spectacular. It's my side garden. There's the front of my house garden. It's all good. No big deal. Pretty damn cool. I'll try to find the link to this place and throw it in the description of the video. That way you guys can dig up the history if that's your kind of thing. I just... Oh, speechless. Whoo! Just try and take that all in one breath. No freaking way. Speechless. Right there, just freaking speechless. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. It is super windy out here, but all the way down the beach, there's all these little bird sculptures made out of driftwood. Let's go check these things out.
I feel the most when I'm alone. I think of you 'cause when you're gone, I remember the feelings, they're hidden in the dark. Never left my feelings shown. I feel the most when I'm alone. But now the rush is longing to be waking up. I belong in your future, but I'm fighting in the dark. your feelings show anymore.
It is so windy outside. You can't do any audio stuff when the wind's just like... Anyway, before I came down here, I stopped at Winners. I don't know, think you guys got Winners in the States? Stopped at Winners and got myself some new socks. I couldn't resist. Sometimes I need stuff like this just to brighten my day. Got some Marvel ones. Got some Tweety Bird ones. And my favorite... Lego my ego. Oh, these are crazy awesome. And some Flintstones ones. Sometimes a little colorful socks in my day just makes my day. This is kind of the perfect van life moment in the perfect van life spot. So if you're on Vancouver Island and you're looking for that Instagram van life moment, it's right here. This place is called Esquimalt Lagoon. Ocean in front of me, freshwater lagoon behind me. How much more beautiful can you freaking get? Well, I mean, summertime here would be freaking unbelievable. It's like 1 degree Celsius out today, so it's kind of chilly, but how beautiful is that? Wow. Actually, the wind's pretty good. Let's go outside. Whoa, I'd scare the birds. Oh, poor birds. People chase that picture-perfect van life moment all the time. They see that captured on Instagram and they're like, I want to live that life. That's what I want to do every day. That's what I want my days to look like. Well, you find those kind of moments here. So Esquimalt Lagoon, Vancouver Island, just outside of Victoria, is like the ultimate Instagram. Guys, it's just freaking perfect. Sometimes you gotta drive around and just drive around and not know where you're going just to find places like these. These places just don't magically pop up and appear everywhere. You gotta drive around and explore like today. Right over there is where the castle is. Literally right there. Kind of behind the shrub of trees, but right there. And then I seen this long little road. I'm like, I wanna go there. That's where I'm gonna go. So I drove around, I drove in and out of areas. It probably took me about 15 minutes to find this little road, but I found it. Just like everything else you want in your life, you gotta get out there and put in the footwork yourself. You gotta go find these moments on your own. Because when you get to these moments, they're way more enjoyable than mapping. I just noticed that there is a whole lot of messed up audio in all the footage that I recorded today. Like, seriously, if you're watching this right now, I have probably thrown away at least 10 minutes of talking out of this video because this microphone kept cutting in and cutting out. I had this problem before, so I did some research on it, and I was told it was the cable. So I replaced and bought myself a brand new cable and a brand new Apple dongle so I can plug this thing into my phone. Still today, had a problem, and I realized it's the wind. It's not that the microphone, come on, this thing, hold on, if this is gonna get noisy. This thing's got a fat wind muff on it, and this wind muff is pulled super tight so it's on there locked in. It doesn't budge an inch when it's on there, but this wind muff is supposed to cut out that wind noise. And the wind noise isn't the problem. It's just as soon as this microphone hits the wind, it cuts the audio in and it cuts the audio out. It kind of, you guys heard it. I'm sure there's plenty of little clips that I couldn't get around in there, but it does. It makes the audio pop in and pop out. It's the freaking worst thing in the world. I would rather deal with the wind noise that comes with my regular Apple microphone in my phone than to deal with the cutting in and cutting out of audio. So Rode Video Mic, I'm not happy with you. Your product sucks really, really freaking bad. The only time this product ever seems to shine is when the camera is sitting dead still, does not get moved at all. And what kind of product is that? How come I can't use your product to vlog with on the daily? I want to, but it's not working. So as of right now, audio is out. Rode Video Mic, your product is garbage.
Do what you do. You know that all I think about is you. Say the things you say.